mentor others. First, you must be well mentored. Then only you can mentor others. How to guide others? How to stimulate others? What is known as work shadowing? If somebody works, you must also work with them without working with them. That is work shadowing. Pair work. If you are not working and sitting idle, they will duplicate and replicate you. So, pair working, work shadowing, simulation, these things are the qualities of these people. So, this is what you have to develop. And some other special skills. One is balancing. How to balance? There are three types of balances. Multi-balancing, intra-balancing and multi-level balancing. What is inter-balancing? Intra-balancing means that there will be a lot of problems with our health, with our mental health and our intellectual health and spiritual health. You have to balance inside. What is multi-balancing? You have to know, you see, if you are a company owner with four or five divisions, you have to concentrate on various divisions on the same thing. You must be a multi-skillful person. So that is known as your multi-dimensional skill which we require balancing. The third thing is, multi-level balancing is, how to manage your son, how to manage your wife. Because most of, just as we know that, most of the people who are domestically having a great affinity are betrayers of the nation. Those who are extremely domestic-centric are betrayers to the nation. Likewise, most of the people who are national-centric are betrayers to their families. You can inquire, if great scientists are inquired about their contribution and their affinity or some other thing to their wife and children, they can give you interesting topics, more interesting than even my lectures. So this is something very natural. So how to maintain all dimensions? I have to take care of my health. I have already told that we spend everything for health in the first half. Because we have spent our health for gaining everything. I told in the recent lecture. The recent lecture of life management. Likewise, we have to have multi-level management of our health, harmony, happiness, the triple H model which I told in the previous lecture. We have to take care of everything. So how to balance and intra-dimensional equilibrium, inter-dimensional equilibrium, multi- or polydimensional equilibrium with various things of the society, that is known as balancing. And second thing is, we are having innumerable things, in taste also, knowledge also. We are having artistic, we are having ethistic, we are having linguistic, we are having creative, we are having innovative, we are having adaptative, we are having operative, we are having mechanical. Innumerable things are there. For example, a scholarly wisdom of a person may be in music. Innumerable shastras are there. It may be Sangeeta, Veena, Venu, Mritanga, Nritya, Nataka, Paka Shastra, Vastra Alankara Shastra, Bhuta Alankara Shastra, Bhautika Shastra, Nirmana Shastra, Vayu Stambana, Akka Stambana, Kanka Stambana, Shukla Stambana, Jyoti Stambana, Bhu Vidya, Akash Vidya, Vayu Vidya, Gagana Vidya, Marana Mohana Vashya Stambha, Mantra Yantra Tantra, Nirmana, Vastu Prakriya, Bhugola Shastra, Charitra Shastra, Anu Vigyana Shastra, Mulan Vigyana Shastra, Jeeva Vigyana Shastra, Sharira Archana Shastra, Vidya Shastra, Mantra Shastra, Jyoti Shavidya, innumerable Vidyas are there. So, knowledge is multidisciplinary in nature, and scholardom or wisdom, it may be also multidisciplinary in nature. All of them compositively, they are working for some sort of development from some dimension of the society. And here, what we have to balance is the hierarchy of knowledge. It is known as bio-neuro, neuro-psycho, psycho-onto and onto-theo models. I'll just give just two examples because it's a very heavy subject. One is bio-neuro. Number one, most of the people's inability to learn and to work even in the professional atmosphere is due to their body damage. They are subjected to a lot of debilitation in nutrition systems also. There are three things. One, if at the time of their uterine residence, at the time of sojourning in the womb of the mother, if the mother is subjected to strong sedatives or high-ended operations or sophisticated collapses of the hormones or enzymes inside the body, it will affect the cognitive style of the things, the baby. And number two, if the child within the first year, if it is subjected to any cerebral attack by means of any infectious diseases like malaria, which may be cerebral malaria, immediately the cognitive tree will be struck. The third thing, if there is malnutrition which has led to the people, malnutrition means it may not be so obviously visible. Lot of obese people are there, it does not mean that the persons are very much nutritious and salubrious. It is not so. That is some internal message which must be culled out only by seeing their resistance, power and sturdity. So, most of the people, there was a Stockholm report in which they say that more than 61% of the modern student community or working people community, they lack of two major facilitators of cognitive drill and exercise known as magnesium and iodine. It is not there in the people at all. So basically, the biological system must be there. There are two types of things. One is known as a lubricant, second is known as an irritant. If you are having lubricant element like manganese and iodine, these type of elements will facilitate you to more read. For example, if you hear something for 20 minutes, afterwards you will feel like somebody is drumming inside the diaphragm of your ear. You cannot resist from walking away, unless you are binded by some affection or fear. Nobody can continuously listen to other people, unless it is something of humor. They cannot grasp message, content, order, analytical study. They can see cinema, they can see cricket, those things are entirely different. They can wait for hours together in passport office and ration shop. That is all. Relishably, they cannot have the patience of sitting in a place, hearing to somebody and watching that. Because of lack of lubricants inside and presence of lot of the irritants, what I have told, in the form of sulfur, calcium, and various other things like sodium, these things are irritants. They are more consumed by people because of their natural consumption, plus the lot of uncountable shower of fertilizers, munificence, and bounty in the modern crop industry. So this is what bioneuro, the impact of your biological misbehavior of food, fertilizer phenomenon, and various other confusions which spoil your neurostatus. And even in your neurological status, there will be blocks. There will be blocks. There will be knots. There will be what we call in Sanskrit, granthi, vyaghata in Sanskrit. So the knots and blocks of your neural structure must be oozed and boosted by your intention, your courage, your dynamic commitment, without which it will not work. So the neuroanalysis of a student is not done. Nothing is done for a student, either internal accessibility or assessment or total assessment by his parents or by teachers or by surgeons, it is not done there. So the neuropsycho, even though the brain is nice, if the mind is corrupt, it will not cooperate. Even if the mind is ready, if the intellectual sturdity is not there, somebody asks, what is the difference between mind and intellect? Mind is something which is very soft, which is meant for transmission. For example, if you want to relish something, it should be powdered, it should be in a pulverized solution for your sublingual absorption. For example, you are taking some pal halwa or something else, it should be soluble. It should be palatable and soluble in your sublingual juice. Wherever you are constructing a house, you cannot select bricks which are soluble. So they require something sturdy for construction, and for consumption there must be something soft. So to gain knowledge, you must be hard, unless you cannot gain. But to give it to others, you must be soft. So the softer mentality of a person is for social connectivity, and the harder or the harsher mentality of a person is for conceptive connectivity. The conceptive connectivity and social connectivity must be there for knowledge management. Without which, if you are not hard, you cannot get that. If you are not soft, you cannot give it to others. So you have to possess both of these things. It is known as mind intellect. So it connects with auto. We believe in consciousness, phenomenal consciousness and connective consciousness. I am aware. I am also aware that I am aware. This is phenomenal consciousness. I am aware that this is a silver tumbler. I am also aware that it is about 2000 rupees. I am aware that it is mine. I am aware that I have to take it back when I am going. So these things are connective consciousness. The more descriptive it is there, more I am considered to be knowledgeable. So ortho theo, we have some other things. Bio, neuro, body and brain. Brain and mind. Mind and intellect, that is sturdity and simplicity. Then to ortho, what is consciousness, what is soul? We only having that knowledge. Then soul to God, the connectivity with the mega spirit, that is the greatness of our system, it is known as onto. So these things are the hierarchies of getting knowledge. Then coming to the real conclusive section, how to get these things? Number one, it is known as garbha samskara. The Shastra says that if a person decides to have an offspring, at the time of the decision, he should make a tapas or sankalpa, a cognitive decision to bear a good child. Number one, at the time of pregnancy, getting all positive thoughts.